namo bhagavate vasudevaya. Om namo bhagavate vasudevaya. Om namo bhagavate vasudevaya. Welcome all to today's reading from Brilliant as the Sun, a retelling of Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 6, Divine Protection. We are reading from Chapter 3 at the moment, Yamaraja Instructs His Messengers. And we'll be reading from verse 19 onwards. You can couple the reading of this book along with the Srimad Bhagavatam. You can find it at vedabase.com. All the cantos are there, and the format is same as it is in all of the Srila Prabhupada books. There's a verse, there's word to word meaning, then there's a translation, and finally the purport. Mukam karoti vachalam pangum langhayate girim yat kripatam ham vande shri gurum dinatarinam paramananda madhavam shri chaitanya ishwaram hari om tat sat. As it always been told that by the acharyas, that we should read the shastras with the help of the persons who have understood them and who are in the disciplic succession. So these volumes of Brilliant as the Sun, a retelling of Srimad Bhagavatam, are by Krishna Dharma Prabhu and Chintamani Dhammataji, and they have put them into very easily understandable language for all of us, and it's easier for us to go through the verses of Srimad Bhagavatam. We look at the verses and then we look at this book, so the understanding becomes much easier for us, especially during the time of pandemic, when we have lacked the face-to-face association, and we've been just relying mostly on the Zoom association, and occasionally in between we have been able to get some association with the devotees. So let us start today's reading. Verse 19 of chapter 3 of Canto 6, Divine Protection. Chapter 6 is Yamaraj Instructs His Messengers. 19. The problem is you are not comprehending religion. So just to give a recap, this is the dialogue going between the Yamadutas and the Vishnudutas here. The problem is that you are not comprehending religion. True religion is whatever Narayan says. I'm not criticizing you for this. Neither the great sages from the topmost planets nor the gods understand this point. What to speak of others? The Yamdutas frowned. The Vedas give the religious principles, do they not? Yamraj smiled. Most statements of the Vedas are meant to keep peace and order in human society. Real religion is transcendental. What is transcendental religion? Asked another Yamdut. Those activities which awaken the soul's love for Krishna. So this is the definition of transcendental religion. It seems few people understand this truth. So the transcendental religion is the activities which awaken the soul's love for Krishna. Verses 20 and 21. Yes, hardly anyone knows, but a few of us do. Brahma, Narad, Shiva, the four Kumars, Kapil, Swayambhuva, Manu, Prahlad, Janak, Bhishma, Bali, Shukadev, and I, we all know the real religious principles. So these 10 names which I've just read are the 10 Mahajans. Can you explain it? So they were very, very exalted devotees of the Lord, these 10 Mahajans. Can you explain it, Maharaj? Yamaraj beamed. Sorry, not Maharaj, Yamaraj. Yamaraj beamed. This was that he liked to discuss. So, Yamaraj is also one of the Mahajans, and fourteen Mahajans. So, contrary to the belief of the people, Yamaraj is a very learned devotee of the Lord. Yamaraj beamed. This was what he liked to discuss, he said. To surrender to Krishna and to awaken our love for him, this religious principle known as Bhagavad Dharma is transcendental to all three modes of nature. Most people do not understand it, but if someone does, he becomes liberated and goes to the spiritual world. Why did Vyasadeva not make this clearer in the Vedas? Yamaraj shrugged. I'm not even sure he knows. The Yamadutas felt much calmer. But now they were intrigued. Can you explain Bhagavad Dharma? Verse 22. Yamaraj smiled. Yes, it starts with chanting the Lord's holy name. That's what Ajamil did. Exactly. This is the ultimate religious principle for living beings in this world. The Yamadutas slowly nodded. It was making sense. Verse 23, Yamaraj sat back and looked at the Yamadutas affectionately. Although you are my servants, I think of you as my sons. You are fortunate to have witnessed firsthand the glories of chanting Narayan's holy name. Ajamil was so sinful, yet by calling out Narayan's name, even though he intended to call to his son, he remembered Lord Narayan and was saved from the ropes of death. So even mistakenly, if someone calls Lord's name, that is also appreciated by the Lord. Verse 24, from this incident, we can understand the power of reciting Krishna's holy name and the pastimes. Its recitation can relieve anyone from sinful reaction. So its recitation can relieve anyone from sinful reactions. Indeed, this is the only procedure, only process, which can completely free us of karmic reactions. So chanting of the holy name along with the pastimes of the Lord, they can relieve us from the karmic sinful reactions. Or karmic reactions. Krishna is so kind that even if someone mispronounces his name, he will still give the chanter liberation from the material bondage. Provided one avoids offenses, the holy name will deliver him from any sin. Just see the case of Ajamil. He was extremely sinful, yet while dying, he called out his son's name, Narayan, and achieved complete liberation. The Yamadutas listened intently. One said, since it is so easy to achieve the highest success by chanting Narayan's holy name, why are there so many other Vedic rituals and ceremonies, and why are people attracted to them? So these are all very intelligent questions the Yamadutas are asking from Yamaraj. Verse 25, Yamaraj nodded approvingly. An excellent question. Sages like Yajnavalkya and Jaimini, who compiled parts of the scriptures, do not understand this secret because Krishna's illusory energy bewilders them. So Krishna's illusory energy bewilders them. Only the 12 personalities I mentioned understand this truth. Others cannot. Sorry, I think I said 14 margins there. There's 12. Earlier on. Only the 12 personalities I mentioned understand this truth. Others cannot appreciate the transcendental value of hearing about, glorifying and worshipping Krishna. Which section of the Vedas did they combine? The rituals in the Yajur Sam and Sam and benefit like the elevation to the heavenly planets. Those interested in these sections cannot appreciate the value of hearing about and glorifying Krishna. They see religion as a path to material prosperity, improved sensual pleasure, and finally liberation from suffering. Verse 26, however, if someone is fortunate enough to hear Krishna's glories from a pure devotee, he becomes intelligent. Such enlightened persons hear and chant about the Supreme Lord, who is the super soul in everyone's heart and a reservoir of all auspicious qualities. I have no jurisdiction over these souls. They do not commit sins, but even if they sometimes do, they are protected from the sinful reactions by always chanting Krishna's holy names. Verse 27. But we all should be still mindful that there's no reason that one should think that they are chanting the holy name so they can commit the sins. One should be really mindful and be careful. Not to cause any offenses to the holy name or to others. Verse 27, Yamaraj took a deep breath and sat in silent thought for a few moments. Then he said, my dear servants, never repeat the mistake you made today. Never again approach someone who has sincerely surrendered to Krishna and chanted his holy names. Such people are so respectable that even the gods and celestial sages glorify them. Indeed, Lord Vishnu protects them with his club. Do not again risk the Lord's wrath by troubling his devotees, not to speak of you. If even Brahma or I were to punish them, Lord Vishnu would reprimand us. Therefore, do not again disturb the devotees. Verse 28, leaving aside great souls who relish hearing about the glorifying Krishna, and glorifying Krishna, bring here those averse to such devotional service and who therefore do not hear from pure devotees, preferring to engage in family affairs. They do not know that such worldly enjoyment is the path to hell. Such sinful people never use their tongues to discuss Krishna's glories or chant the holy names. They never think of Krishna or bow before him, nor do they engage in any duty for Krishna's pleasure. Bring me such fools and rascals. Verse 30, folding his palms, Yamaraj prayed, my dear Lord Narayan, please forgive my servants for their offense. O Supreme and Oldest Person, pray forgive us. Because of ignorance, we fail to recognize Ajamil as your servant, and thus we have certainly committed a great offense. Therefore, with folded palms, we beg your pardon, my Lord. Since you are supremely merciful and full of excellent qualities, please forgive us. We offer you our respectful obeisances. Parikshit and the devotees in the assembly raised their arms and loudly chanted, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Moved by the history of Ajamil, many of the ascetics joined in. Verse 31. When the assembly quietened down, Shukadev said, my dear king, such congregational chanting is the most auspicious activity in the entire universe because it can uproot the reactions to even the worst sins. He turned to face everyone in the assembly. Please try. To understand this, then help others to take it seriously. Verse 32, again addressing Parikshit, he added, He added, anyone who constantly hears and chants Krishna's holy names and discusses his pastimes will easily attain pure devotional service, and his heart will become completely purified of all ignorance. No other method of purification is as effective. Verse 33, by constantly chanting Krishna's holy names, a devotee will eventually experience the Lord's sweetness. He will never give up Krishna's service and return to materialistic activities. Those enchanted by hopes for material enjoyments who neglect to hear and chant about Krishna may perform acts of atonement or the prayaschit, but not being completely purified, they will continue to sin. Parikshit said, Master, what did the Yamadutas do after being instructed by Yamaraj? Verse 34, Shukadev smiled. They were wonderstruck on hearing about the extraordinary glories of Krishna's names, fame and attributes. Since then, they fear Krishna's devotees and dare not even look at them. How did you hear of this wonderful story? History? Verse 35, I heard that the great sage Agastya, Kumbha's son, had gone to the Malay Hills to worship Krishna. When I went there to meet him, he told me about this confidential history. So this brings us to the end of chapter 7. Yamaraj instructs his messengers, and next time we will start chapter 4, Daksha meets Lord Vishnu. Thank you for joining. Hari Om Tat Sat. Hare Krishna, Shila Prabhupada ki jai.